Tea. Earl Grey. Hot. What's up, everybody? There is no tea in this thing, by the way. Guess what? There's a new Star Trek show coming up! Star Trek Picard! I wonder what's it about? Interesting. I'm just kidding. It's about Picard! Captain Jean-Luc Picard! I hope I didn't offend any French people with my bad accent. Anyway, I have a bit of a love-hate relationship with Star Trek. As you can see, I'm wearing the Star Trek comm badge. And by the way, this is specifically the Next Generation era comm badge, because I think at a certain point in Deep Space Nine, they actually changed the shape of this thing, and then subsequently Voyager had the different shaped one, because, well, if you know anything about Voyager, spoiler alert for a 20 or 30 year old TV show, well, they got lost in the other side of the galaxy, and therefore they were forced to wear the exact same uniform that was popular at the time the show began, even though they switched uniforms in other shows. Anyway, Star Trek. Like I said, I have a very love-hate relationship with Star Trek, meaning I both love it and hate it. It's kind of hard to explain. Yeah, I sometimes really love Star Trek. I sometimes despise Star Trek beyond belief, and I kind of question why am I even bothering to watch these. I love all of the movies, by the way, the ones that I've seen at least, but yeah, the shows, so far I've watched the original show, the animated series, The Next Generation, Deep Space Nine, and I'm currently about halfway through Voyager. I haven't gotten to Enterprise yet, and I certainly haven't gotten to Discovery yet, so no idea how those look like, but yeah, like I said, the shows are hit and miss for me. More misses than hits, unfortunately. Yeah, I really don't like a lot of the stuff that Star Trek is doing a lot of the times. But that's beside the point. Picard is actually one of my favorite characters, shockingly. I'm actually more of a Kirk person. I prefer James Tiberius Kirk to Jean-Luc Picard, but that's just me. By the way, I'm wearing also the rank of a captain, just like Jean-Luc Picard was at the time, unless he's already an admiral, by the way, but in this show. But apparently the show is going to be about, specifically about Picard, 30 years after All Good Things, which is the series finale to Star Trek The Next Generation. And, well, spoiler alert, if you've watched the finale, Picard's retired! Yeah, he's living on a French farm somewhere, and he's growing grapes and making wine. So I don't even know what type of a show can you base around a premise like that, unless, you know, something happens. Maybe Geordi shows up from out of nowhere and decides to take Picard with him to, you know, I don't know, go on one last mission, and then he somehow is entangled with some new Star Trek BS thing or something. I don't know. I mean, we did see kind of glimpses into Picard's future in All Good Things. But then again, this is Star Trek, so things kind of change whenever they do these future sight types of stories. And, well, I'm not very interested in what the show could look like based on the finale, but then again, I mean, like I said, it could change. So let's just watch the teaser trailer for Picard. It's only about a minute or so, so don't expect too much. Let's see what's Picard been up to. By the way, I'll bet you $50 Q is gonna show up. Not specifically in this trailer, but in the show, because I mean, you kind of have to. If you're making a show about Picard, you have to put Q in there, for obvious reason. Anyway, let's watch. Make it so. The grapes.
15 years ago, today, You led us out of the darkness. You commanded the greatest rescue armada in history. Then, the unimaginable. What did that cost you? Your faith? Your faith in us? Your faith in yourself? Tell us, why did you leave Starfleet, Admiral?
Admiral? Come on! Space, the final frontier. Oh, wow. I love it, but I want more, damn it! Ah! Why did Picard leave Starfleet? Maybe he finally got some sense knocked into him and realized that all Starfleet are basically a bunch of morons. And believe me, this is part of the things I hate about the show. I mean, I'm sorry. But Starfleet is an organization run by idiots, and speaking from experience, by the way, I've been to the military, and I know how these types of organizations work. Honestly, admirals in Star Trek, other than Kirk and apparently Picard, because he had the good sense to leave, admirals in Starfleet are bunch of morons, from what I've seen, at least, from the TV shows. And, it gets worse the higher they go in ranks. So, that's my opinions on Starfleet. I'm so glad Picard decided to leave it, but apparently something is gonna force him back into Starfleet. I wonder who he's talking to. At first I thought it was, what was the name of the doctor? The doctor character that I forgot her name, but it doesn't sound anything like her. Bottom line, Picard left Starfleet, finally, and nobody knows why, and that's what Starfleet is trying to figure out. And like suggested in the finale, he's living on a French farm somewhere, and he's growing grapes and making wines, which is exactly, like the finale, even down to the smallest details, even the farmhouse looks exactly the same. So, I love it. If you couldn't only tell by the excitement on my face, what do you guys think about this thing? Do you like it? Do you hate it? Are you excited for a new Star Trek show? Do you absolutely hate everything in the new Star Trek and you prefer the originals? Because why spoil perfection or something like that? Let me know, and until next time, guys. Warp 9. Engage. Hello again, everybody! I really hope you enjoyed this video, because I really enjoyed making it. So, if you like what you've seen here, please remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe for more awesome content like this. So, until next time, guys, I'll see you guys next time.